like, well, they're not horses, cows or bulls or something.
Yeah. Bull fights.
No. Bull riding, not fighting.
This looks like it would have been a great motorcycle riding place to camp and stuff, like right down in here. You can see all kinds of dirt trails. But one time this is probably all ridden in here.
It looked like there was a little wash or a little river.
Yeah. Those are dirt bike hills.
Yeah.
Those have been fun to drive on. Pull off, go down that road, camp over there.
Is this where you fell when we first met?
Yeah. Yeah.
This car?
Yeah. See that road? Now this is a Sundance Meadows. This is a horse camping. You can go there with RV. It's an RV resort. Horse riding.
Horseback riding?
Deal, yeah. And Vail Lake is just right on the other side of that hill. So you can go camping there. You want to go horseback riding. Come this way. Go through Temecula and come around this way. It's less.
Oh, here's Confluence.
Look at that valley back in there. I mean, that school was built in 1897.
Where is that? Oh.
Right there.
I see
trees.
It. I see it.
This is good.
There's a horse over there.
This is a neat little.
It was it looked like a pony.
This
dog.
This is a neat ranch. They have a really neat water feature right here. Place to sit. Little pond.
Yeah.
You see it? Koi pond. I don't think it's open to the public.
It almost looks like it is.
It might be a dude ranch, you know. Very
kids
private.
Go stay.
Very private. They don't advertise, that's for sure. There are large ranches here, like with hundreds of acres back in here, that they stock with game, and then they allow honey.
Aww.
Yeah, the game preserves. Panthers.
Panthers?
Yeah.
No, sir.
Yeah. You're talking way back in the country there. And they have electrical fences so they can't get elephant.
Elephants? You're crazy.
Not elephants, but definitely, you know, those kind of things.
Mountain lions and stuff?
Yeah.
I didn't know it was.
But more exotic. More exotic animals.
And it's legal to shoot them?
Yeah. If you're on private property. You can shoot your, it's like shooting your dog. You can shoot your dog if you want.
It's animal.
Okay, now we'll get on the freeway here. I'm gonna turn around.
Huh?
I'm gonna turn around. Okay. It's okay. Chili.
First year, there were so many rooms.
Well, you didn't want it because Coco.
I know, she can't eat it. So. They're bad for her. So I was picking them up all the time.
So it's probably good that we don't have. I've not seen any rats. There's no food source back there. Of course, they eat plastic.
They eat what?
Plastic. Electrical wiring.
That timer fell off the...
Stays cool.
There's a lot of glass. A lot of windows. Oh, that looks like a little cottage. Yeah. Wow. Sure got green.
Grapes? Good water source, that's for sure. It's probably well water.
So well water is water in the ground?
Yeah. Camping places along here.
There's a house.
Yeah.
A hill over there. A little creek. out here aren't afraid of snakes.
No. They don't come around.
They don't?
No, they try to avoid, be away from people.
Well, how come it was in somebody's backyard then?
It was a juvenile. So you didn't know what the heck it was doing. About those two guys that were hiking in this area.
Yeah, what happened?
One got bit by a rattler on his wiener.
Oh, you're so full of
it. And
it's a joke.
No. And so the guy, his buddy, says, okay, well, lay down. You know, you're not supposed to, you know, get your blood pumping because it just spreads that venom throughout your body. What you do is put a tourniquet to keep isolated to that one part of your body. Which they had to do it around his wiener down there. And so the guy took off, saw a ranch, you know, about a mile away, went there, and said, hey, explained to the situation, some old rancher guy in his 80s, and explained to him what happened. And the rancher said, okay, what you do is take the snake bite kit, you cut an X into the bite marks, and then you suck out the venom out of the wound. He says, what? He says, yeah, just cut two incisions, it'll make it bleed, and then you suck out. You need to pull out that venom. It's typically how you do it. So he goes, oh, okay. So he walks back to his buddy, and his buddy's going, oh, it hurts. I'm feeling the effects of it. What'd you find out? And he says, his buddy says, you're gonna die.
Yeah, I knew it was a joke.
Oh, have you heard it before?
No, but I can tell.
How could you tell? You're
starting to talk about it.
How could you tell?
This isn't a bad drawing.
Feet.
restaurant, bar, and real estate. Motorcycle-only parking.
No car up there.
Must not be open. There's no car there.
It's probably a biker hanging out. Dig the top soil down about an inch or two.
Oh, Love Acres Ranch.
It could be cooler down there.
Boy, then you must be able to ride all around here. Looks like a nice path to ride a horse on.
Sunshine Summit?
I don't know when they open, but...
Probably weekends.
Huh?
Probably the weekends.
Probably on weekends.
They don't come around.
They don't?
No, they try to avoid, be away from them. people.
Well, how come it was in somebody's backyard then?
It was a juvenile. So you didn't know what the heck it was doing. About those two guys that were hiking in this area.
Yeah, what happened?
One got bit by a rattler on his wiener.
Oh, you're so full of
it. And
it's a joke.
No. And so the guy, his buddy, says, okay, well, lay down. You know, you're not supposed to, you know, get your blood pumping because it just spreads that venom throughout your body. What you do is put a tourniquet to keep isolated to that one part of your body. Which they had to do it around his wiener down there. And so the guy took off, saw a ranch, you know, about a mile away, went there, and said, hey, explain to the situation, some old rancher guy in his 80s, and explain to him what happened. The rancher said, okay, what you do is take the snake bite kit, you cut an X into the bite marks, and then you suck out the venom out of the wound. He says, what? He says, yeah, just cut two incisions, it'll make it bleed, and then you suck out. You need to pull out that venom. It's typically how you do it. So he goes, oh, okay. So he walks back to his buddy, and his buddy's going, oh, it hurts. I'm feeling the effects of it. What'd you find out? And he says, his buddy says, you're gonna die.
Yeah, I knew it was a joke.
Oh, have you heard it before?
No, but I can tell.
How could you tell? You're
starting to talk about it.
How could you tell?
This isn't a bad joke. Wow. restaurant, bar, and real estate. Motorcycle-only parking.
Little car up there.
Must not be open. There's no car there.
It's probably a biker hanging out.
Are they?
Well, pilots might crash on the ground. Boats might.
Yeah, I guess they have to have.
Crash on the ground.
Ground training. Well, if you got bit by a snake and you made that X and you sucked out the blood, how would you know when you got enough blood out?
Well, you don't, but you do that at the same time you're going to get help.
They give you something to, they give you a shot that will reverse the effects of the,
yeah,
the poison does.
Yeah. It has to thin the blood, counteract that coagulant that is in their venom. I used to have a snake bite kit, and it had, the case was a rubber case in two halves, and those were the tool that you used to create the suction. You don't really do it with your mouth unless you don't have a snake bite kit, because the problem is if you accidentally swallow some of that stuff,
then you'd be dying.
Yeah, and it could get in your mucus system, in your, yeah, so it's not all together. What they did in the pioneer days. It'd be like siphoning gas. You try not to get the gas in your mouth, but you always do.
Have you ever?
Siphon gas? Oh, hell yeah.
Did you get it in your mouth?
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, God.
I drank a little bit of that stuff.
Well,
give me a beer. Let me wash it down.
How come you're alive? Didn't you spit it out?
Well, you try, but sometimes if it's down in your throat, you can imagine.
Yeah.
Like a torch.
Hello, George.
But when you fart, you put a match down there. That's how we light campfires.
Oh.
Hey, who siphoned some gas today? Oh, Joe over there. Okay, Joe, we gotta start the campfire. Get the weenie. Roast some weenies. Little guy humor.
Huh?
Little guy humor. So far, this road's pretty good.
Yeah.
I've come down here in the motorhome.
Yeah. It's not a windy mountain road. It's a little curvy road, but
yeah,
it's not a windy mountain road.
This is actually perfect. Off the freeway.
I know. And even though it takes us long, it's not as far.
It takes us longer because you go slower. You're not doing 65.
Well, we would want to go slower anyway.
didn't hear.
I said, I guess as soon as she knew I was back in the car, she was okay.
Dinette and everything in back, or the bed in back.
So you can sleep in there and you can shower and
cook? Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's self-contained. Looks like he's from New York.
Oh, look at all the places they've been.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Cattle crossing next April.
Gas in Utah is about 50 cents a gallon cheaper. I was looking. I like to go on that trip. Problem is, it's pretty hot right now.
What?
I'd like to go where we planned, to Utah.
School that size.
Well, there's ranches all, you know, back in. They may come from 10, 20 miles away.
Yeah. Might take them a half an hour to get to school.
They may have a morning session and an afternoon session.
There's that many kids.
Splitting the grade levels so that there's less rooms, you know.
Or they just have, they don't have 20 kids probably in the classroom. They probably might have 40 kids in the classroom or something.
Or they could break them up into 10 kids in a classroom with a teacher running around. Or they could, who the hell knows?
You wouldn't get to know very many kids, you know, in a little school like that.
Yeah. 92 degrees. Oh, there's some water there.
I should have brought the Beach Boys CD. Or the Four Seasons, I mean. not sitting there. Time needs to stop. They must be having lunch. It's 11:45, 10:12. I don't know where they are. One guy sitting in this truck. There's a few guys sitting in the truck.
I think it was my back muscles were like a little strained from stretching. So try and do some stretching exercises. You gotta do something.
My arm better.
Good. Now you can rub my back.
Well, it's my right one anyway.
Those would be kind of neat to have, but you couldn't really like pull a toad with one. And every time you would be hooked up and you'd want to go someplace, it's the problem of not having to unhook.
It's too little. It'd be real cramped up.
Plus, there's no space, right? Fuel economy's not going to be that great. Love our RV.
Oh, me too. So when do you think you want to come up here? We'd like to pay appointments.
I'm thinking that
next week or the week after.
I don't know.
Can't shop.
I don't know, but I'm thinking next year, the month of July, we need to take a trip to Oregon and get out of this area during July. It's too damn hot. And Oregon's the only place you can go. You can't go. I mean, you can trip along the coast of California, Northern California, that's fine. But you can't go to Arizona. You can't go anywhere other than north, west, northwest. If we go up and see your brother, Yakima, you know, make a trip. Make it probably a 2 or 3 week trip. In July, and from November to March, go to Arizona, Yuma, Tucson, your cousin, you know, go to Arizona.
I don't mind going for a longer trip, but I'm going to pay Nelson or somebody to water because I want my plants to look good.
And then, you do what you want. And I'm not going to let the plants keep me from taking a $100,000 motorhome and use it.
No, but don't give me a hard time.
I'm not giving you anything. I'm just saying, don't give me a hard time because I want to go out.
No, I said that's fine.
Because you've got, you know, a $2 plant that.
That's
on a sprinkler system, and somehow you think you need to have somebody else.
Take care of the plant.
Well, then don't make it an issue.
Well,
you brought it up. Why are we talking about it? I didn't bring it up.
It won't be an issue.
You brought it up. Don't bring it up, and it won't be an issue. It won't even be a topic of conversation if you don't bring it up. I'm not bringing it up. So don't bring it up. We won't have to talk about it. any maple?
I didn't see any maple.
Those look like cottonwoods. Hey, there's a little ranch.
See any horses?
Cows.
Oh, cows. Oh, they didn't show us the shade. Where we can sit outside. Well, I think they're going to keep Tiffany. You do?
You know, typically what happens...
Is Paul going?
No, they're going to get Bronte. Bronte.
Oh, and Bridget didn't say Bronte. They're going to break up that little line.
Well...
Because Natalie's already with James.
Well, and she's Bronte's buddy. Natalie and Bronte are the girl team. And they're not quite sure about Bridget. Because she's been
doing too much that Frank wants.
With Frank. And then now Bridget knows that Frank put a Bronte.
Right.
And she says no big deal. You know, one of those kind of things. And so
this is Santa Isabel.
Same thing here?
Julian Fry Company. Left to Julian's at the moment.
This is a perfect day to come here.
See, that's an apple pie counter restaurant.
What this town's all about.
Santa Isabel.
Oh, the
little shops.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, typically what they do is they always change at the end because game plotting continues and it matures. And it never never make sense to get rid of Tiffany when a large part of the house wants to get Frank out because he's playing so hard. Tiff would be the person going after him. To get rid of her, to keep Bronte, who wants to come after the other. I mean, it's like the reverse. The problem is that both the people want Bronte and Frank out. So why wouldn't you get the people out when you can that are up there to get them out?
Oh, look, we have turnouts if we need them in the motorhome.
Oh.
Coming this way.
Great. That's good.
And here's another one.
Yeah. Good.
They're pretty. There's another one. They're close.
Where's the other one? To Bridget. So where do you think you're going now, Frank? Who put your best friend
Bronte
up there? He could have put anyone up there. What does he do? He puts up Melissa's or Bridget's best friend. Thursday, but during a week, about this time, and you can see there's no traffic. Any later, you're going to have work traffic coming back here.
You mean when we come in the motorhome?
Yeah.
Look at that house up there. It's
wow.
A big two-story house.
Sit outside there.
Pizza again?
That was one damn good pizza. That fruit stand. That was one damn good pizza. I'll say.
Julian Pie Company place. place to sit outside and eat. You know, right when we turned off, we turned left, and it was right on the right.
What was that?
I said that Julian Pie Company looked like a real nice place to eat.
Oh.
And it had nice outdoor seating in the shade.
Back there?
Uh-huh.
Oh.
When we turned left.
Why didn't you say something?
Well, I didn't know if we would eat right now. We'll go up here and look. We can always eat on the way.
I don't want to eat at 3 or 4.
Well, I don't want to.
We won't be back there till 3 or 4. So we won't be, we will not be eating there. Flat area where there's a water, where there's water, you know, it's sort of flat, there's water. It's kind of a meadow.
Hey, there's our trees. There's a church.
Yeah. William has
Girl Scout camp.
Julian, 1 mile.
Entering Julian Historic.
What's so historic about it?
I don't know. You have to do a video on it.
Oh boy. Well,
Scrimshaw Studio.
I'll have to walk around town holding the selfie out. Then you have something to say, people? Yeah, we're now in this little shop. We gotta do that. I'm gonna hold the camera on you.
No, these houses.
I can't. Other than the road.
You need to jump in that house.
Hunker jumped?
Well, it was a clothes thing when it was packed. You know, like a bar of clothes and it was just packed with clothes.
Stop and get out and walk. Wake up a little bit.
Oh, we will. We're almost there. We're a mile away.
I got pee. I just took a break. Is there a public restroom around here?
Mexican food.
Here you go. Which way?
There's our public restroom right there.
So I want to call you then. Where?
I'm turning that driveway right behind the silver car.
And where?
Oh, I saw it right there.
Uh-huh. Tell me where. You never saw it.
Let me see. Well, now I don't see it. Oh, it's over there. Turn left.
Turn left?
Turn left. Go through the parking lot. Oh, turn around.
Going.
Doesn't go through. It's the next
just tell
one.
Me where it's at, and I'll
it's
decide.
It's the next one over.
I will decide how I get there. Just tell me where it's at.
It's the next one over.
I saw a handicap ramp. You're not confusing that with bathroom, are you? Public restrooms right there.
You have to pay. See, there's one there.
There's a fee? Oh, I guess I don't have a chance. Choice. Do you have to go?
No. Do you have a quarter?
Is that what it takes? I'm going to have to.
Do you need a quarter?
If you have one, yeah. You want to go in after me? I mean, if I knew where we were going
to
eat anytime soon, I wouldn't waste a quarter. What is it?
Let's see, it's a grill.
Is there any outdoor eating?
Yeah, whole outdoor eating area right there.
Well, let's turn around. We can go there.
Okay. There's a parking place too.
Looks like it ends there.
Looks like what?
The town ends.
Oh, yeah.
So? Might be more than what I'm looking for to eat.
Huh?
It might be more than what I'm looking for. That looked like a pretty, like a full dinner menu.
I'm sure they have lunch. It's 12 o'clock.
It doesn't look like anything here, huh? I guess we could park, get the stroller out, and go for a walk. Is that pretty much?
Yeah, well, we'll check out. Check out, see what they got.
I think that's it here, huh?
I mean, it looked
the
prettiest, shadiest place.
Here's a cafe. Here.
It's not very shady.
I think there's any more of that way. I think that's pretty much the downtown area, wouldn't you say?
I would say.
Okay, if you want to go there, we can.
Well, if it's, I'm sure it's lunch too. I wouldn't just have dinner. They probably have hamburgers and.
That's all I want is a hamburger.
Sandwiches and salads and stuff. I'll go look at the menu.
There's nothing. No outdoor eating along here. Did you want to go walk up and down these shops?
Well, maybe after we eat.
And then the stroller? And
yeah.
I didn't see nothing down there.
No.
This looked to be about the coolest. Mm-hmm. Hey, these opened up.
You want me to go check it?
Whoa. Yeah, see, it's steaks. Seafood, spirits.
Well, they may have.
Yeah, go take a look. If they have hamburgers, I have a hamburger. As long as it's not some triple or triple, yeah.
You go stay here with Daddy.
Stay here. Okay. You stop it.
Sidewalk.
Uh-huh.
Shh, shh. Stop that. Coco, stop it.
Coco, how you doing? Going bye-bye? You getting in the car? Did you clean your face today? You better clean that face. So peaceful and quiet out here. Except for Coco.
There's dogs in the ocean.
No, I gotta turn around. I think Julia or Wisconsin's that way.
Oh, that was the trickiest. You're really sure.
Julian, we want to go make a right. Then we want to go down 79.
Is that where we just came from?
I don't know. Is that 79?
We came up 79.
We want to go Cuyamaca.
Okay, it's
yeah, we want to go down that way.
Oh.
It says that way, right?
Yeah, it says turn right here.
Right there. Or up there.
Up there.
Up there, okay.
They don't make the turn after the turn.
They don't?
No. It's where that bus is going.
There's old city, no Sooner because it's closer to Julian.
Oh.
once we get past Gaikama Lake or whatever up here, Gaimeka, then Descanso Oaks and Eat is on the other side of that. This works gets tricky with the motorhome. It might be easier to come around the Oaks and Eat them, you know what I'm saying?
That house over there.
It's 20 miles of this in the motorhome. You look like
well,
that.
Yeah, but they've got a way bigger one than we do.
It's longer. That's with water and power, no sewer.
Here, it's right here. Pines and
Eden. Wanna look at it?
Yeah. Oh, that wasn't it. This is it. That's storage. Just drive around.
Well, we probably need to check in.
It says register an office over there.
Oh. Not here?
No.
Well, do you want to go in and tell me we just want to drive through the area?
Yeah.
I'll
get some
information. Let me pull up there. Get a little map or whatever.
Oh, you're pulling up here? Then I gotta walk all the way up.
If there's parking over there, then fine. I imagine this.
Yeah, it is. There's lots of parking.
I plan to come here, make reservations, 2 weeks out, come to, oh no, there's no sewers.
Okay, well.
You can water the trees with your gray. What about the black? Well, when you leave. Okay, so we'll never dump our black tank the whole time we're here.
And how many times, well, it usually dumps all the time. When you have full hookups, it always dumps.
I'm not looking to pay the fees that they want and not be able to flush, empty my black tank.
I know, but my question was,
what?
When we have full hookups,
yeah.
It empties the tank as you use it, right?
I go out every day and dump them.
Oh.
Because they fill up. You know, we flush the toilet and that kind of stuff. We flush it.
Yeah.
And we're not...
We rinse it out so it doesn't
it. I mean, we could fill that tank in a day. I'm not going to disconnect every day and pull out and go to the dump station.
I think Oaks and Ada is the same one.
I doubt it.
Huh?
I doubt it. I've never heard of anything. What it is, they don't want to run dump sewers to other sites. They want to rent them to their snowbirds on an annual basis. And then okay, I'm sure everybody wants a sewer site. So why would you plan to come here and then, lo and behold, no, we don't have a sewer. Well, your whole plans were based to come here with the sewer. So who needs that headache? And then she wants to kind of be argumentative to conform to what they want.
She was just trying to sell the clothes.
Well, I know. But she was questioning and doubting.
Okay, well, let's try the next one.
You know, we'd like to put people over here. It's quieter. And we put all the families over here. Okay. What's that mean? I didn't like that right off the bat.
Well, I'd rather be where the kids aren't yelling and screaming.
Well, we're not going to come here during the summer.
Yeah. Well, unless this one's different, I'll go to this one.
If we're going to boondock, essentially, is what...
Except they have water and electric, right?
Well, what I mean by boondock is we could go to a national park campground where they have water. Some have electrical. You pay $15 a night. And then there's dump stations. If we want to do that, but they wanted $2 for this, they wanted $29, then they wanted $2 for this, they wanted $5 for that.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, they had a sign out there. I think if you wanted to use their restrooms, that was an additional fee, because no one wants to use their black tank. They don't use the is a 1,000 trails. It's going to have everything. Yeah, I mean, that black tank is only it's a 35 gallon tank. we were to stay there, you know, 3 or 4 days, then figure every time you flush the toilet, you're probably looking at, what, maybe a couple gallons every time you flush it? Plus whatever goes down there adds to it. So you might have 5 flushes for every 10 gallons. You might have more. But it's not just going pee, you know, it's, I mean, poop, it's going pee. So you might have, let's say, 6 flushes a day per person. And that takes care of, 6 flushes would be 10 gallons. Or let's say you get 10 flushes, 1 a gallon. I think in 2 days, 3, you might need to go.
Oh, there's like 5 flushes.
Anyway.
I have a restaurant
on
6 a.m. day.
Campgrounds here, and they have water, they have electric, they don't have sewer. Okay, this to me seems a lot nicer than that place.
It's right on the lake.
It's right on the lake. The thing is I'm all for staying at a place, we'll come back this way. I'm all for staying at a place without sewer hookups. If I'm planning, and I'm paying a price based on no sewer hookups. But with the hopes and expectations that sewer's going to be available and then not have it.
They have sewer, but you might not get it. That's what's...
There's no guarantees. Well, yeah. Okay.
I mean, if we get sewer, but it's going to cost this much money.
Yeah, I want guarantees for the site that I'm planning to use. Not for them to say, well, no, you only get half of what you need. Well, then you got to anticipate that from the very beginning before you make the reservation. Can't be on the hopes that you get.
Here, next time.
Let's stop back there because that would be nice, that little area. That seemed to be rather cavernish. I get my
beer, wine.
I can get a little inflatable canoe. Or a raft.
That's a nice little restaurant store.
Yeah. This is where we want to come.
Lake Kalamata.
Is that camping? Picnics, huh? For boats. Well, we'll stop by there in a minute.
Well, that was why we came up here.
Yeah, didn't want. That's what you thought we were going to do?
Yeah, yeah. I thought we were going to check out places to camp.
Right. Rancho State Park. not so sure about dumping your gray water.
Well, if it's just soap and, you know, water, it's okay because the soap's going to kill plants and kills bugs.
Yeah, but people are going to wash food down the drain. Now, where's that? How's that being dispersed? And is it drawing flies? And you know what I'm saying? I mean, there are health rules about gray water in the city. You can't.
Not seeing signs to Oaks Anita.
Well, because it's a ways down.
Or is it just all of a sudden you're at Oaks Anita?
Could be, just like that. Pines Anita. This is beautiful down here, isn't it?
Now that's a meadow, right?
Yeah, now that's a meadow. Exactly.
And this is a meadow.
This is a meadow going through here. It's beautiful here.
So it's flat land.
See, this is kind of like Yosemite. Back up in Tuolumne Meadows. Very much like this. Let's get down to Oaks and Eden, then we can come back.
Wait, what's it? Is it past the sun? Okay.
Okay. What?
There was some kind of campground there.
Yes. We're going to go to Oaks and Eden, then we'll stop at the places along the way. On the way back. We can see everything that we've got to stop at. We got that one, and we got the lake one.
Campsite.
And then all of a sudden it comes up.
Right. I mean, it's not exactly a landmark. There was a telephone pole and there was some bushes.
There was a bush.
Yeah.
There were three bushes. Three bushes in a row.
Yeah, and a curb sign.
Okay, I gotta come down in here.
Okay, one of these.
Yeah.
Actually, there's not so much traffic.
Well, I got some guy that's gonna wanna ride my ass, and I'm not gonna be screaming. Down the center of the road.
Careful, honey. Can't pass him.
No, he's not staying to the right, idiot. people used to go off, drive off there, go camp there.
They did?
Yeah, that's why they blocked that off up there. Have that one turned off?
No, I moved it over that way so it wasn't pointed. Whoa.
Yeah, that's a narrow road. Well, there's a camp right there.
Self-registration information. We'll ask him some questions. Oh, day use. Horse camping, $30.
Horse camp?
Here, he's waiting desk.
Well, I'm trying to see what they got here. Well, okay. Hi. What can you tell me about this place?
Do you have water sewer hookups and all that?
I can look. I can look at your sign here and find out what you got, I guess. I just tell me about your place. Okay. Well, I spoke first. Anyway. Thank you. No, everything's on the board there. Thanks. Oh, he wants to stand there and ignore me and talk to you. Fucking people.
Do they have
I asked him to tell me about it and he ignores me and then answers your question.
Do they have sewer?
No.
Oh.
I mean, what a dickwad. Tell me about the place. And then you ask a question, he starts talking to you. I mean, I can read the sign. If he's not going to just kind of tell me about it, I'll read the sign. I don't need to hear any more what he has to say. $30, no sewer.
Yeah. I think the others were $34, no sewer. Fine speed.
If I want to stay at a place where there's just nothing going on, I'll just stay at that one with the lake. It's going to be cooler. You can walk around it, hang around it. Here, you're just in the middle of a bunch of
dry brush.
Oxanita.
Springs, 500 feet. Oxanita Springs. Can't be that. That's a horse trail. I would think it would have some kind of an entrance there.
You think so?
Looks like it. And come back.
I don't see anything about Oxanita.
Well, it's got to be it. 500 feet. Oh, 1,000 trails. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Where's the office?
I don't know. Stop and register. Right. I guess you stop here.
Oh, is there something?
I guess we want to find out if it's a pay members only. Hi, is this a members only camp?
We do some retail, but mostly membership. So,
do you have sewer hookups here?
Just under half the campground. Yeah, it's more of an RV resort, but there's some camping as well.
Well, we have an RV, but you say some. What qualifies for some?
Somewhat. Which
well, you said some. We offer some retail, so I'm just.
Oh no no, we allow retail in. It's just. Membership, if you make a reservation, members get priority, kind of thing.
Okay.
And we're completely full this weekend.
Oh, well, yeah. we're looking for like probably fall, September.
Yeah, no, I mean, as long as you call ahead of time, or you can even go online, 1000trails.com.
Yeah, we've seen
it. Let me get you a map and brochure.
Okay.
And that way at least you have contact.
And can we call ahead and reserve a site with the sewer?
No, it's first come, first serve. We don't reserve specific sites, not even with our members.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Oh. It's frustrating sometimes, but that's the way they've always done it.
Okay.
So is it $5 extra if we have a tow car?
No, you can have two vehicles per site. It's just if you add, say, another guest or someone coming up for over 3 hours for the day,
oh,
we
no,
charge extra for that.
It would just be our RV and our tow car.
That's fine.
Yeah, so. We have a 30-foot Class A with a towed. And so we're just kind of checking the area. No, we live in Hammett.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we got a swimming pool, jacuzzi, miniature golf, horseshoes, that kind of stuff.
Oh.
There's a lodge. You can watch TV in there. There's a fireplace. We get very quiet in the winter.
Her father-in-law and mother stayed here like in 90.
My stepdad and mother.
Yeah, stepdad, and they have like some old VHS videos, and they were in the snow. It was snowing. It looks like they were like up there, and they had about a foot of snow.
Yeah, we've got hiking trails, and there's places to go up there, and we get snow almost every year, at least a dusting.
Yeah.
About every 8-10 years, we'll get a foot, but let me let them in.
Okay, thank you. Well, so there's no guarantee on hookups.
Mm. Well, ask him if we can take a drive through anyway, just for the heck of it.
You're welcome. This is a map of the campground. There's some information inside, and if you guys are interested in membership at all. We're right here at the Ranger Station.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Campground split in half. You go to the right here. These are nice sites back here, but the green have no sewer hookup.
No sewers. Okay.
These are our big 50 amp sites.
Yeah, we need to see 30 amp.
Yeah, and then so to get there, head towards those boulders and hang a right, and that takes you up above the campground. You explore all that.
And then what's over here?
Most of these orange ones.
Yeah.
Have sewer hookups.
Oh, they do?
Yeah. It just gets a little bit tighter up in here. Some of the sites are kind of small. There's a few big ones. So now if you're coming in the off season, you probably have the pick of, you know.
What's the off season that you consider?
Winter. I mean, some in the fall.
Like after, like October?
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, okay.
Even beginning in September, you know, about middle of September, but definitely October.
Oh, when the kids all go back to school, it really lightens up.
It does. You know, we do have there's some employees on the grounds. I'm one of them. Mm-hmm. And we do have some annual sites where people pay to stay 7 months out of the year. So those sites are taken.
Sure. Okay.
But if you guys want to just drive through,
if we could,
and take
that'd
a look,
be nice.
Yeah, I'll let you do that. To get out, come back on the other side of the ranger station here.
Okay.
Okay, right in this
just
kiosk
right around
here. Okay.
There's a gate right here.
Okay.
Pull up to it, it'll open for you automatically.
Okay.
What
great.
Kind of tree is that? It's so red.
This
it's
is a manzanita bush.
Yeah. Oh, it is?
Yeah. We got a lot of them up here, which in Spanish is little apple, and they get these little green berries that taste like a Granny Smith apple.
Oh, really?
Do you have oak manzanita trees?
No, that's a we have oak in the manzanita, and we got a lot of live oak, as you can see.
Yeah,
so.
Okay.
All right,
well,
if
check
you guys
it.
Need anything, info, whatever, come
okay.
get us.
Okay, thanks a lot. I appreciate it. Probably.
It would be fun to stay here since Mom and Harlan did.
Yeah.
And he said hang a ride at the rocks.
Right here.
I think so.
Yeah.
Campsites. A sites that way. Pool. We want to go see that anyway.
This way?
Yeah. It says A sites. Pool. He said hang a ride at the boulders. That's the boulders. Barking when we talk to somebody.
I'll think of us pulling the motorhome here without the toad on.
You could do it. If Harlan could do it, you could do it.
Ours is bigger than Harlan's.
Oh, okay.
So that goes down that way. You want to go down there? Or
sure.
We'll come back.
We can go check it out. There's a restaurant, which I could probably use.
Do you want to go?
Before we leave. But I don't have to go right this second, but I'll take a minute to use me. It shouldn't be locked. Oh, look how shady.
I think he was like up in one of these spots. You know that?
Harlan?
Harlan, yeah.
Well, there's the horseshoes. Volleyball.
So they had no sewers over here. I don't think they had a problem with sewers. Your mom. Mm-hmm.
They got a dog on the table and a bed. All the kids over here. There's tent camping.
Sure doesn't look like anything special, does it? I mean, other than, you know.
No RVs found at this point. Okay,
so where? Oh, there? Yeah. How close are these people to one another? I got a feeling they were up there though, because it was up on a hill. I'm going, holy shit, how are they going to get down with their snow?
Oh, here's a swimming
pool. Oh, okay. So these are no hookups here.
Yeah, these are the ones on the right.
They just
over here.
Yeah, they have.
There's the swimming pool, so we want to go up there.
Yeah.
Look at how pretty the pool is, and there's not a soul in it.
Yeah.
There's some people sitting out here. In the little 3 foot pool, there's nobody in.
Well, now these people here, how do they dump their tanks? Oh no, these got sewers. Oh, these have sewers here.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
That's where the TV and all that stuff is. Probably a store.
Yeah.
Look at that house up there on top of the hill.
Wow. Yeah.
Camp a lot.
They could have been up there.
Let's go up here. B sites. So the B sites are this way.
I know that he was up. These don't have sewer here. Anything green. Now we're getting up here to some sewers. He could have been up here though too. And see, his motorhome was as big as ours. He was probably a couple feet shorter.
I thought they had a 32 foot or something.
I don't think so. Did he?
Yeah.
That must have been one of those later ones.
They had a bathtub in theirs.
Wow.
They had a little small bathtub.
Boy, that's some nice. Of these people look like they've been here forever, don't they?
Yeah.
Are these?
Sewer. These are sewer.
These people are like full-timers here.
Yeah, some of them over here are.
Yeah.
They're here 7 months out of the year.
He could have been at any one of these that are high, now that I'm looking at it.
Yeah. You see sewer?
I don't know, man. Somebody could pull in there? Shit. Yeah, it kind of looked like sewer. Maybe
there's
not.
There's another
there.
One.
No, no sewer there. See, there.
I see sewer. What is that little plug thing over there?
Oh, I don't know.
Do you know the sewer spot?
Could be. But they have to, we pull, yeah, I guess. Now this one here, 26 doesn't. That's 23. That does. 26 right up here doesn't.
Well, this is kind of like being in the mountains, it looks like.
This doesn't have sewer.
Oh, okay. This one does. They're hooked up.
Yeah.
And they got tents and everything.
Boy, they're packed
all
in there. They are packed.
Yeah, but I saw
some
empty ones. This is an empty one right here.
Yeah.
Pretty hard to get to. Go straight ahead.
Well, I'm gonna go around this loop.
Oh.
We come around.
Oh, there's a bear trap. Or a doggy trap. Oh.
I don't know. He was saying it's pretty tight up in here. It is.
Well,
of course,
how these people get up here?
I know. These people got trailers up here.
They got sewer right here.
Yeah. Boy, what a job it must have been pulling their these trailers up
sewer.
Here.
Sewer. Well, I don't know. How are they? There's another sewer spot.
Yeah.
Harlan must have been pretty good. Here's empty spots.
That Harlan, he was a brave one. That's all I got to say. I don't know if he was, like, really on top of it, or there's a part of him that just was sort of, you know, not overly exact.
I think he was. Probably wasn't as persnickety as you.
Yeah.
But he wasn't afraid of much when he was younger, I'll tell you. Here's another empty spot. But, you know, they probably just have...
Well, I just don't want to have problems. You know what I'm saying? I've had a lot of problems in my days because of poor planning. And as I get older...
That's sewer, right?
Yeah.
An empty spot.
Boy, that's right on top of one another.
Yeah. It's an empty spot with a sewer.
Place up there.
I think we'll plan on coming here maybe in October. Might be real pretty.
Well, it'll be real dry. We should be here maybe more.
There's a nice spot right there.
More in April, I think, really.
Not in the fall.
It's going to be so dry. It'll even be drier now, you know.
There's a site right there.
I would like to see it green. You know, now that I'm thinking about it, there's horses here.
Oh, you can have a horse here? Look at all the horse corrals. A bunch of them.
Yeah.
How cute. I want to get a horse.
Now, there's no cable here, I don't think, is there? Good cable?
I don't know. We'd have to watch movies.
Well, you know what it is? These people are 1,000 trails. And what happens is they can park here for 2 weeks for $10 a night.
But it's so expensive to be 1,000 trails.
Well, but they're full-timers, and so...
There's a sewer.
Yeah. They're full-timers, so that what it turns out to be is it's like a house mortgage, you know.
There's horseshoes. Uncle Bob, there's horseshoes for you.
In fact, one guy was saying he bought his membership, okay, for X thousands of dollars. You know, it could have been 5,000, could have been 25,000.
I wish I would have known that we were going to be together someday and have an RV, because I could have bought Harlan's membership for $200 and some for a lifetime.
Wow.
And I just didn't do it, but I'll probably never use it. But I should have bought it, because I could have sold it. And I didn't think about that. And I would have had a 1,000 Trails membership. Would have, could have, should have, you know?
A lot of up and down here. I really don't like this kind of camping, to tell you the truth. Now, how do I get out? Right there.
Go on the other side of him, right here.
No, I go out here.
Yeah.
These
this
people.
Is the other side of
these
it.
People are pulling in.
Yeah, this is the other side of that. He's open now. Oh, the dog's laying down. He's
wow!
Trying to walk
look at
it.
This. They got these big fifth wheels are pulling
my God,
in here.
It's huge. So we don't like this.
Well,
I liked it.
Huh?
I liked it.
You liked it. I mean, we may. I'm not saying no.
Now, this is going back, right?
Yeah. Now we'll stop along the way and check out what you want.
Well, we stopped at that first one, so we just need to go to the lake now.
Yeah. It's probably going to be close to the same. You know, because they're all kind of governed. I mean, the guy just wouldn't answer, tell me about the park. Well, what do you want to do here? What kind of fucking question is that?
I don't know.
What a dipshit. I don't know what's with these people thinking they can talk to me that way. I'll just ignore them. They're going to come off that way.
Yeah, you better get over, buddy. Damn. That was a Corvette, wasn't
it? I was an idiot. That's on a double yellow. And he turns his lights on like that. It's supposed to mean shit to me. Don't be in my way. I don't care about seeing you in my way.
Well, you can't count on these idiots making it, so you gotta slow down. Give them a chance to get in, or we'll end up in a wreck, because they don't care. They just soon end up in a wreck. Half of them.
Oh, I want to change this memory card out.
Why don't we stop at that lake when you can? was the best tuna sandwich I think I've ever had out.
Really?
It was really good. Thank you, honey.
You're welcome. Thank you. Thank you for coming along.
Well, I wasn't going to stay at home.
Is if we're going to stay at these state campgrounds, is we can get a senior pass, and it takes gives you a break.
Cost break. Oh, price.
Yeah. Those are for like chains. If it snows, there's a place for people to put chains on or to stop and check this little meadow, this little mesa here out.
Is this Camp Kayamuka already?
No, it's, well, it's another campground. It's some school camp.
Oh, yeah. I see visitor school camp.
It's more of an interpretive center.
Cabins over there.
Yeah.
It's kids that stay in cabins. Go to camp.
Yeah.
That's neat for kids to get to do. I never got to do that. Of course, I had a hard time after my junior year of being away from my mom for a week when I went to cheerleading camp. You know, it's a whole week.
Yeah.
We left on a Sunday and came home. My mom, couldn't wait to see her, and that's when I fought with her all the time. But I was so glad to be home. Of course, I was with Linda Davis. You know, she was a cheerleader too.
Yeah.
And Jackie. Jackie moved to Utah. But when Carol's husband passed away, Jim, you know, he went to school with us too. When Jim passed away, Jackie came. I saw her. And she doesn't come very often to stop because she's in Utah. But Carol and Jackie lived two doors from each other, I think. So they were real close. So when Carol's husband died, Jackie came. You know, Carol's the one you met when we went and got the pictures.
Place got torched, didn't it?
Yeah, some place it looks like it did. It's weird because it just looks like it burnt part way.
Well, what you have is a lot of new growth, though.
Oh, that's what it is.
Yeah.
It burned, and then the new growth. growth is taken over.
Exactly.
And that's why it's green amongst the brown.
Right. Because this place is burned probably down to the dirt.
Oh, yeah. Down to the burnt trees.
Well, like these bushes, these are probably all new growth.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. This probably happened 20 years ago. Because that's all new. That would have been just all burnt dirt.
Maybe when Ma and Harlan were coming up here.
Exactly. I bet you if you were to Google it, you'd find it.
Because 20 years ago would have been 96.
Yeah.
And that would have been when they were coming up here.
And I think, well, they were here actually before that. Those videos of Hope's Anita.
5 and 94.
Were, no, probably 91, 92. They're early. They're their first ones. And then, come to think of it, I don't think there was another Hope's Anita. Which you would think there would have been. They probably didn't come up here because it was all burned out. I'll have to, you might need to Google it. It's probably called the Hope's Anita Fire. But I do remember a fire down here years and years and years ago.
It's almost, you know, Julian fire.
Well, but
it seems like I remember a fire up by Julian, too. Come to think of it.
But this isn't Julian. This is more Descanso.
Well, I know, but a lot of people don't know that, but they know Julian. You know, near Julian or something. Okay, great campground.
Went to that idiot.
Oh, I thought that was the other one.
No, that was the idiot.
Oh. We passed another one then. I thought that was the
guy. No, that's where the guy was. Couldn't answer. I mean, couldn't tell us anything about it. He's only there to answer questions. Well, what the hell? I can read the board for that kind of shit. I've been camping too long to have people tell me what I have to, constraints I have to live up to in the camp. They can tell me what they offer, and it's up to me to decide whether or not it fits or not.
See, that guy's a little camper thing.
But I'm not going to debate it with them.
lot of times meadows have grass and clover and stuff too. Right?
Well, I would like to get up to Yosemite. Is you want to go to the desert in fall because you're not going to miss the desert's going to look pretty close in fall as it is in spring. You know, it's rock and you know what I'm saying, and sand.
Here's that Lake Cuyamaca restaurant.
That camping?
That was the camping on the lake, wasn't it?
Was there restaurants here?
Yeah.
Or restrooms?
Restaurant, store.
I don't know.
I don't have to go that bad. I can leave.
I do. I don't know that I want to go. That looked more like a boat ramp, didn't it?
Oh, okay.
I think that's what we decided. The campgrounds are on the corner.
Okay.
That's where I want to go. Check it out. Right through. There. I get us a little inflatable boat that can roll us around the lake. Absolutely. Thing starts leaking air. You're gonna be swimming.
Bye bye.
I'm putting a life jacket on. Two of them.
On me?
Yeah.
And one on Coco.
Oh boy, she can swim.
No, she's getting a life jacket too.
They don't have life jackets for her.
They do too.
Tie a balloon on her.
They have life jackets for doggies.
You just tie a little balloon on. Can we go in here? Please pay first at tackle shop. Fishing.
Adults, $8. This is fishing. Day use. Uh-huh.
This is only a day use area?
Yeah. Lone Pine.
Well, there's a trailer there.
Well, maybe that's a guy in charge. This is for picnics and stuff.
Lone Pine. There's campgrounds here. What's that sign all about?
No fires.
Wait, it says here, welcome to Lone Pine. Permits required for camping. Fishing, picnic, no one allowed in water, no fires, keep dogs leashed. So you can't go swimming in this lake.
No. You can't even put anything in it, probably. So oh, yeah, we've got people in that boat.
Do they have restrooms here?
There's a little outhouse
in there. Okay, these people are camping.
Watch out, this thing right in the water.